My name's Joshua Balderson, and this is the Hockey Nation. Hello, everybody. Joshua here. Let me give you a little bit better angle. There we go. So I am here in Gananoque at the Lou Jefferies Memorial Arena because we're going to be bringing you the game here between the Gananoque Islanders and the Smith Falls Rideaus. We have a special here tonight. It is the Gananoque Royals night here. So the Gananoque Royals are in full charge here to support their Gananoque Islanders, and it's going to be a great game. If you didn't see the game last weekend, Gananoque faced off against the Smith Falls Rideaus, and they were able to take that game 6-2 for the victory. Gananoque did face off against Smith Falls in Smith Falls earlier this season on November 18th, and that score was 6-6. It was a tie. These teams are playing each other four times this season, and Gananoque right now holds one win, one tie, and they're looking here to get two wins and make sure they're going to take the season series. We'll jump you guys over here actually real quick over. If you see, the Zamboni is just finishing, and you will see on the ice there, bench, lots of little hockey players. That's right, they are the Gananoque Royals. They're getting ready here for this start to the game, as it is a celebrating night here for the Gananoque Royals here at this game against the Gananoque Islanders. We can show you here the crowd is pretty full and still filling up, as there's some in the other room. The away is not too full, but not full as they're getting in there. We are getting into the final. 5 minutes before puck drop. And I'm going to give you a little bit of information here on these Gananoque Islanders and these Smith Falls Rideaus. We'll just pull it up here. I'm just getting my camera reset as we go into this. So far this season, the Gananoque Islanders are holding a 2.63 power play percentage and a 7.86 penalty kill percentage. Smith Falls has a little better on both sides with a 3.27 power play percentage and a 7.86 penalty kill percentage. Gananoque is on a three-game win streak, and Smith Falls Rideaus are on a one-game win streak. So we'll see which win streak gets broken here and where it goes. Gananoque is holding a 6.5 goals for average, and the Smith Falls Rideaus are 5.8. They sit second and third in the standings right now with 17 points apiece, even though Smith Falls does have one additional game in play. So Gananoque can get an additional 2-3 points. Who knows with this league? So quick here, and not in the lineup though, today is their top scorer, number 61, Ryan Verbeek. Ryan Verbeek has 31 points in 8 games. He's not playing today. Justin Stevens is in the lineup, and Justin Stevens is sitting second. And then Brock Higgs is also missing from the lineup today with 18 points. Chad Duchesne is in the lineup though. Let's see if we can find it here. The refs are making their way onto the ice. So soon we're going to have the players coming on. Just to give you a quick over here, Andrew McKinney, he is in the lineup today. He has 16 points in 12 games. Calvin Watsiak, probably screwed that one up. Number 3, he has 15 points. He is in the game. Spencer Cobble, number 23, is in the game, sitting there with 13 points. Ben Beasley's in the game as well with 13 points. So top four scorers on the team right now for Smith Falls are in the lineup tonight. Gananoque missing a couple top scorers. So we'll see. Sorry, wrong button. Pop you over here. You can see the doors open up to the Islanders' dressing room. They will be making their way out here shortly. Pop you guys real quick over here. As you can see, a large number of Gananoque Royals. They're at the glass, getting ready. They're excited to see this game. It is the Gananoque Royals night here in Gananoque. We'll give you a quick shot here in on those Royals as they're all ready to go here to cheer on the Gananoque Islanders. I think you're gonna see here, the doors opening up down here, as onto the ice is gonna be coming the Smith Falls Rideaus. The refs are on the ice. Just as he starts his announcement, the Islanders are coming onto the ice. They were let on the ice by Lee Pertz, who will be playing in net for the Gananoque Islanders. And I do believe we're going to have Dallas Slack in that here again tonight for the Smith Falls Rideaus. They're the officials today. It looks like there's only a three-man lineup system right now. I don't see the fourth official. There's Dallas Slack, put on a great show. Lots of saves last game. Couldn't stop the onslaught again, Gananoque. As you can see over here again, they're all lined up at the boards. Here to cheer on the Islanders.
The Royals all took up indigent burden, and they had all four, five Royal teams up there playing on the weekend. The five Royal teams combined for 22 wins and only one loss.
See there, presenting the banners is Duchesne, Coda, and Selleck.
True patriots love and honor.
with the setup, and the game is going now as Gananoque will win that faceoff to start off this game. Gananoque trying to get some pressure on here. Smith Falls will take that one back in their zone. Smith Falls is wearing those blue and red jerseys. Gananoque in the gray and green as out comes number 14. Devin Cobalt takes it in, tries to get towards net, but it comes around. This chipped out to center, picked up here now by Duchesne. As he's going to come in, he's not alone. He has Salik with him. Cross ice and a shot and goal. Here scored by Chad Duchesne, and that goal was scored quite quickly into this first period here at 19:22, so 38 seconds in. Eric Selick makes it 1-0. Smith Falls doesn't want to get caught into a game like they had last Friday, so they'll look to start getting the pressure here back on Gananoque. Gananoque was able to keep a significant lead for the majority of the game. Shot on, saved up by Slack. Face off one and sent back to the point. Shot in, but got chipped on. And now grabbed up by Pilon. Sent to center ice. Then grabbed up by Mercier. Then back, but was taken over by Tim Morton. Former Gananoque player Tim Morton. You'll see now they're coming back the other way. Spins it back over to the board. Chopped up and sent in. Drive now in for the Rideaus. And we have a goal as that was scored, I believe. We'll double check here to see the one leading that pack. But I believe that may have been Nate Slack that was able to put that one in and get a tie game here. Yes, that is number 19, Nate Slack, tying this game up here early as Raveloy played down 1 minute and 11 seconds, and we have two goals here in this game here at Gananoque Royals night at the Lou. Face off. One back into Smith Falls territory as they're going to backpedal. Costello puts over to the far side and they'll chip it up to the neutral zone. Sent in, but broken up by Alex Reese. And then spun back all the way down. He's going to go for icing. The call was Slack from Bennett and Morton. Morton has to be happy to put a point on here as it was his old team now playing with a new team. Always great to get that off the shoulder right away from the get-go. Now Murray gets it up the center and sent in ice as there's a little bump. That's in on Slack and a little bit of a dangerous one as that one bobbling. Slack will gobble that one up and hold it, and they'll take the whistle here as this game being a little bit of a slow start. Two quick goals. But the action here in this game, not too much coming yet, as both teams are just seem fine just chipping it in. There is two goals, so don't let that fool you at this point. Face off, one deep in, grabbed up by Beasley, carried by the net, up the board, tries to chip it to the blue line now, a drive in by Boucher. Trying to get it in, can't get to it as Gananoque retrieves it, chips it in the slot, and a battle gets broken up as it gets broken off onto a Smith Falls stick at the blue line. They take it from their back to their net, back player to player, and Costello gets it up, tries to center it. But Hale had gotten in there to break that up. Reese puts it back the other way. Break now, here comes Costello, comes in, shot. That one's gonna go off to the side of the net there and picked up quickly by Selick. Turned back the other way, it's gonna go all the way down for icing. As they'll come back into the Gananoque zone, it did clear everybody. Face off, one back to the point. Walking the line, shot in on Hertz. Save made as no rebound came out. the first registered shot here so far on Hertz for the Rideaus. Witzel trying to win that one back, but Cota gets it in behind his net, and they'll get wrapped around to the boards. Up to center ice as they're going to carry it in over the blue line, tries to get to Stevens, but that puck gets intercepted, and now coming back the other way is the Rideaus. Cobalt comes in, drives it, sends it forward, save made by Hertz. Picked up by Gananoque Stevens, but he has a little bit of problem with it. And towards the bench, and it gets bobbled. Now picked up by Cota, sent in. Cota gets bounced off the puck by Cobalt. That's Devin Cobalt. There's Devin and Spencer in the game, so I got to get used to the two different Cobalts. But icing is going to be the call, coming all the way down here at 16:56 in the first period. 1-1 is the score as Gananoque's Selick was able to get a goal, but then was responded on quickly by, I can't remember which one. I think that was Slack that got that one, number 19. Face off, one shot high, glove save made as it comes over to the boards. Battle, Mercier picks it up, takes it in deep, tries to chip it towards the net, but can't get it there as that puck stays over in the corner. Now coming out is the Rideaus. They chip it in, but they can't connect with the sticks. They're going to go in deep behind the net. Stopped up by Chad Duchesne as he carries it now. Sends it up ice. Du Mercier comes in over the blue line. Chips it in deep as Slack's going to come out of his net. Play it and chip it back around the board. Leah Murray comes to it first. Grabs it. Shoots towards the net. And it just goes short side. Missing the net. Comes out to the other side. Chipped on. Kept almost in the blue line. But Mercier had to come back out. Sends it back to Murray in his own zone, who will turn it back towards the Gananoque bench as they're unable to connect. Colin Brown trying to chase that puck down. Can't get to it as now it'll be carried and chipped out to the neutral zone. Murray chips it back into the neutral ice, and now a drive here as it goes in. Slack leaves it behind for Costello, who's going to send it up ice to Herbuck. Opportunity coming in the zone, and Pilon almost got it alone in the slot. But that puck now turned over. Stevens coming back, has Beasley chasing him down. We're able to break that puck up off a stick. Brown comes in for a hard hit, but that puck makes it out to the blue line as Wiley chips it back, leaving it there to be picked up. Picked up by Stevens, who chips it in deep. He's going to have Brown go in and chase that puck down. Takes a bump, but Gananoque gains control, sending it back to the point. Misses everybody and goes all the way down onto the stick of Hertz. He leaves it for Hale, who picks it up and drops it back to Wiley. Wiley now takes it back behind his net, using it as protection. Chips it up, but it's intercepted by the Rideaus shot. And a good glove save made by Hertz. Off the turnover there again, very dangerous. They're lucky to walk away with a nice, easy glove save there for Hertz. Face off back to the point left, but they try to get in the intercept, and they do chip on it. Comes out to the other side. They're unable to get a piece of it, and it's sent back in by Slack. Now they got to turn it back. A little bit of complaint there to the referee. That puck in the slot almost got onto by Hale. Latimer spins it back in behind his net as Hale now on it. Centering opportunity, can't get it there. And it's just out of the reach of Dixon. It gets sent back as Dixon turns back. Latimer does a good job driving the player off the puck. And then they're able to clear that puck down to the neutral zone, back into Gann's zone, in behind their net, up to the sideboard. So Reese can't get a handle on it. Goes in deep. Reese keeps with it and able to pick that one up. Has it behind his net. Sent it over and send all the way up the ice. Spring Cota gets to the puck, stops up, sends it across to the slot, and Selick couldn't settle that one down to chip it in. Chipped up behind that. Selick still pressuring, trying to get it out to his center, but couldn't get a handle on it as it goes in a point. Puck momentarily kept in the zone, but then chipped out, and it's grabbed up by Cota. Cota back. He has some support, so he has some time to chip it up. But wobbling in the feet of Selick, he couldn't find it. The Rideaus are able to get control again here. 13:40 remaining in this first period of play. That puck over to the far side, stopped up on the stick by Mercier, who's getting some issues with Ty Nicholson behind the net, but now it's chipped out. And oh, almost getting a step there. Was getting awkward, but a great play. Breaks that one up. Now coming in, Nicholson shot. Save made as Hertz hold that one into the chest with 13:19 remaining. End of the faceoff. Gananoque sets up. They win it back. Comes over to the far boards. They can't get it out. Was able to chip that out, and they try to drive it in the zone, but taking off his feet was Mercier, and Slack got to that puck first, got off the boards. Nicholson couldn't get a handle on it. Has now an opportunity. Mercier has it in the slot, looking in, shot, and that one high off the glass, gonna come off the boards, picked up by Duchesne. Duchesne backhands it towards the net, but it gets intercepted by the Rideaus as they're gonna skate back now the other way, drive with the puck, coming in the zone, drives it in behind the net. As they look for an outlet to pass the puck, gonna send it across ice, broken up by Reese. Reese sends it, but it goes between the feet of Mercier, and they try to get to it, gets chipped back down to the Smith Falls zone. Now over the far side here, as it will be chipped in by Beasley. Beasley then trying to enter the zone again with it, can't get it through, as it's turned back into Doman. Doman had to avoid getting hit there by Devin Cobalt as he was crashing down on him and made a good move to avoid that check. Costello sends it up ice just off the feet of Witzel, and it'll get dragged into by Marison. Now coming out of the zone is Costello in over the blue line, takes a shot, hit a leg, and now get chipped out by Gananoque, but only to center ice as it's recollected back by the Rideaus. Tim Morton carrying it along, comes in, drops it back to Spencer Cobalt. Spencer Cobalt dealing with some pressure, tries to center it out himself, but it goes over to the far side. They try to curl it back in, now in behind the net, as Witzel has it. Witzel spins, centers it. And Devin Cobalt tried to get a hand on it. Wiley Cobalt collided there over on the sideboards as it gets chipped out. And Bennett collects that puck. Bennett stops up in his own zone. As Selick is pressuring, he'll take it behind his net. Selick curls off as now Bennett comes out of the zone, trying to dodge. Selick couldn't get onto him as Stevens gets it, chips it back. He'll send it over to Coda. Coda comes in, drops that puck back, leaves it. Selick comes in, cuts back towards the net, shot, grabs the rebound, but can't settle down as that puck's chipped off his stick. Kept in the zone, they try to leave it. Rassell couldn't get it to him. Coda kept it in, Selick shot. Save made there by Slack. And that will keep that puck out. What a first 9 minutes and 21 seconds this game has been here. They are keeping it entertaining as both teams are pressuring. Faceoff one back to the point, on to Dixon. Dixon shoots it, gets chipped through the slot area. That's gonna get sent all the way down the ice. Hertz has to play it. Now it's chipped out. Stevens comes in, stops up, tries to lead that puck. Coda gets a stick on it, pulling it into the slot. Can't settle that one down. We're broken up momentarily by Mason Mangan. And then that puck comes in, gets broken up. Faceoff won by Gananoque, back in the zone. They try to get around the boards, but it gets intercepted by Smith Falls, now out of the zone. And Gananoque is gonna carry it in. They couldn't get that one to settle in. Cross onto the net as that's in behind now. Gananoque giving some space. Costello's gonna have time to carry it out of his zone. Gets it to the blue line, carries it in, up over center. Trying to break it through. Gananoque is able to break that one up. And now they're gonna drive and try to push that one in. Up into the netting as that puck is gonna come out. Right out front of the Smith Falls zone. The Falls holding possession after they won that faceoff. Chips it out. Gets up Nicholson. Nicholson chips it through to Wasiak. Shot. Save made in the slot as that one dangerously sitting there. Scramble. Puck gets chipped up and over to the glass. Nicholson still trying to get out, but got broken up by Hale, then out in front of the net. Awkwardly almost cost Gananoque. But they'll walk away with that one fine. Face off, one back over the court, picked up by Liam Murray. Carried up to the blue, chipped out. Now they're going to drive it in, out of the reach of Reese as he gets into a little bit of collision there with the Smith Falls players. That one goes down into the Gananoque zone, picked up by the Smith Falls. Duchesne pinching off Wasiak, just misses Nicholson as it comes over to this side. For now, Murray will get up to Reese. Reese will send it through, takes a big hit. As that looked like that might have been a little bit of retaliation for the hit, as that was Wasiak that got the hit on to Reese, who was able to put him over into the bench on last week's game. So we'll keep an eye on them as he could be looking for a little more retribution. That might not be all of it. 8:50 remaining here in the first, as this is a 1-1 game. Puck chipped out of the zone. As into the zone, Wiley has to stop up on his net. He is being pressured hard here. And now you can see Smith Falls starting to put on the body checking and pressure here on Gananoque. Into the zone, shot on by Marison. Kick saved over to the boards. Puck cleared out of the Gananoque, or the Smith Falls zone, now into Gananoque. Shot, couldn't make it through as it goes off into the corner, picked up by Wiley. Wiley makes a couple of little moves, stuck on his foot, and it does get chipped out to center, but it is onto the stick of the Rideaus. They chip it to the blue line in the zone, and they'll send it in around the backside of the net, as over to the far side to grab it will be Selick. He avoids getting hit as he gets sent back to Marison. Marison now behind his net has it. He's going to take a couple steps and sends it over to Selick. Selick has it, sends it up to Stevens. Stevens carrying in. Shot. That one just wide of the net. As we had a whistle here, I'm not exactly sure what caused or initiated that whistle. I don't think that puck went up out of play. The faceoff will be to the left of Slack. Faceoff won by Gananoque, back to the point, shot on. Slack got it, scrambling for it, but still able to hold it. Now, a little push and shove there by Costello in on Selick, but nothing's going to come of that. Coda is going to come in to face off against Nate Slack here on this faceoff. There seems to be some discussion going on with the official, with the scorekeeper. And now they are over talking to the coaching staff here for Smith Falls, giving them a little bit of explanation. Now back to the faceoff here as Coda versus Slack. Faceoff in the feet, comes out on the stick of Costello. As out comes the Rideaus, sent in is Alex O'Neill, sent that puck in to Hertz. Hertz almost got tied up with Latimer, and that gave an opportunity for a shot to come from Costello on the point. Hertz was able to turn that one away. Puck now grabbed up by Gananoque as they're going to try to send it out the ice, and that's going to go by everybody for icing. 7:01 remaining here in this first period of play. 1-1 is the call, or is the score, as both teams have been able to get one goal by the other team's goalie. Slack on Kotas. Slack wins it back, and a shot by Costello gets by, and I think that one might have been straight in from the point with no tip, and Costello's going to lead the pack with a goal here, giving Smith Falls the 2-1 lead. It looks like, from my advantage point, that one cleanly beat leave hurts. It may have been a screen on him. It could have got tipped, but from my viewpoint, it looked to me like it did go straight through. During the announcement, just like that, number 47, Ben Beasley snipes one from the right side, far out on Leif Hertz. And this has to make you start to question, will they be pulling Hertz here? Z has, it looks like, 3 goals on 6 shots here. And it is 6:48. He's still in the net. He's looking downward. We'll see what happens here if the coaching staff makes a change. But I'd have to guess another goal will be the end of Hertz's night here. Another great opportunity for... as this game might start to get a little bit rough here. As you can see, Gananoque is going to start initiating the hitting game as they don't like to be down. And now they are sitting down 3-1 here. They only have 5 shots up on the board. I'm guessing it is 6. It didn't change after the goal. But at this point, either way, not a good save percentage so far for Leif Hertz. Great other zone. Murray gets that puck, spins it back the other way quickly, but couldn't connect with anyone as Smith Falls now has the possession. They'll spin up the center. Again, possession not being held by Smith Falls as Gananoque gets it now, as this game has a lot of turnovers here. And a stretch pass, can't connect, causing an offside and bring that puck all the way down into the Gananoque zone. Off of Obi Bouchard versus Whistle. Oh, sorry, that's Hale. Hale versus Whistle. Hale will be tossed out. Stevens is going to come in. Stevens versus Whistle. One by. Oh, sorry, McCarty. McCarty was the one who came in and won that one. I do apologize. Didn't get that number properly, but another icing. Going to bring it all the way back down for another face-off. I'm guessing Hale will come back in now for this face-off attempt. Shot from the point. Hertz makes a save, puts it off over into the corner as they're going to try to battle. Hale trying to pull that one out, chips it out, gets it over to Curtis Marison now. He's going to have that puck. Carried across the blue. Sends it, it'll be chipped in by Reese. And they will get some fresh legs now on the ice here. Hucking still behind the net. I can give you a little bit of an update. They do have 10-7 on the score sheet. So the score clock, again, not matching the score sheet here. So Hertz having 4 saves here on 7 shots. Drive in by Spencer Cobalt. Trying to get on that puck. Puck comes back onto Stevens' stick. And then chipped up by Bouchard onto Selleck. Selleck trying to get that one in. Stevens has it. Leaves it. It couldn't be grabbed up. A little bit of shove there. Selleck trying to get that puck. Has that puck now. He's able to wait up. Gets the puck. Takes a little shove. And that puck goes to the far side to Latimer. Latimer now with the puck in. Sends it in around. That's going to be a whistle. Faceoff will be inside the zone. Coda will face off here against Nick Pilon. And against a scrambled draw, it is one on by the Rideaus. They take it behind the net, over to the side boards, as they're going to try to get this puck up and out of the zone, curl back, as they have to leave it, as they have too many people converging in on them. Puck in behind the net. Now drived up, chipped up off the boards to the blue line, broken up again by Herbert. The Falls content right now with killing off some time in this period. Picked up by Dixon over to the far side and chipped up the ice. Tipped on by Doman, but he couldn't get it by the defenders as they're going to hold it back and now send it over to the blue line. It gets chopped on as they can't get a connection here. As it gets sent to center. Chip play made, grabbed up. Now the puck is on the stick and a charge shot came from McCarty as he tried to get that one, but Slack handled it easy, put off into the corner, and now Smith Falls takes it out the other way. Chipped it in deep into the zone as they go for the corner. Puck gets left there, a little bit of a draw battle there with Latimer back behind the net, but he couldn't get the player to engage with him. They turn it back, now an opportunity here for Smith Falls as they send it in on an offside. That one was close, but just outside here at 2:55 remaining in this first period. Smith Falls is holding a good lead here against Gananoque. And this one's going to go all the way down, it looks like, to the blue line just outside the Smith Falls zone. One back. Murray sends it in. That one's... looks to me like it hit maybe the ceiling here netting. And we'll come back out. Faceoff will be at center. Bouchard goes in against Slack. Slack wins it back. As now here comes a drive. As Bouchard tried to push through but couldn't get through them as it comes out on Costello's stick. Now a stretch pass for a drive. In comes the Rideaus shot. And that across trying to get that with everything he had, but just couldn't get a hand on it. And Andrew McKinney makes it 4-1 here. With the what I can make out of the score sheet online, it looks to me like it's still holding only a 50% save percentage. Hertz may not be making it back into the net here after this period. Turning opportunity shot. Save made by Slack. Rebound. And another save made. As Mason Megan was right there on the doorstep trying to walk that one by Slack. But he shuts the door too. 10 remaining here in this first period. 4-1 is the score. Shots on the score sheet online, not on the scoreboard here, is 11 for Smith Falls, 8 for Gananoque. So, 4 goals on 11 shots. Little better than a 500 save percentage now at this point. Shot from the point from Wiley, saved up by Slack. By Wiley. And he gets in to get that puck, gets it over to Marison. Marison has it on his stick, sends it across the ice, but gets broken up by the Rideaus as they turn it at neutral zone and back in. They chip it in deep as there's going to be a chase now. As onto it, Wozniak can't get to it. As Marison gets it over to Wiley, Wiley has it. Makes a move through the center of the zone, chips it on a backhand up two. The attacking Islanders shot in, and a good save made by Slack. Rebound grabbed up. Shot from Wiley, saved by Slack, and then they send it out of the zone as he had a couple good opportunities there on Slack, but couldn't get one by him. Coming up to the final minute of play here in this first period. 4-1 is the score. And Gananoque needs to do something in their game plan, as right now it is all Smith Falls. Good play by Latimer to break that one up. Got it. Hale kicked it back to him, but couldn't get a hold of it. Now a move here. Witzel shot. And that one goes off over into the corner. That was Witzel the shot. I get him and Beasley mixed up. Now an opportunity. And oh, what a great chance for Spencer Cobble, but he couldn't get it in on the open part of the net. Reese tried to chip that one forward, but it got broken up here at the boards. Sent up by Cobble. And that one's going to go up and out of play, causing a whistle with 29.4 seconds remaining in this first period. Smith Falls in a much better position right now than they were last Friday night here, holding a 3-goal lead on Gananoque. Oh, Smith Falls will be going to the dressing room with a smile on their face and a game plan of how they're going to beat this Gananoque team, as right now what they've come into this game with is working. Offside called now, only 5 seconds remaining here. Always fun to try to make out what this scorekeeper sees. As he said, it was 10-5. Now they have 10-10 up on the shot, and they have 11-11 on the score sheet online. So always a little bit of a guessing game of what the shots are. Never believe that score clock in Gananoque. Maybe the goals and the time, but never, ever are you going to believe those shots. So where are we sitting right now? Well, Smith Falls holding quite the lead here. 4-1 is the score, and they, again, tied in shots with Gan, both having 11. Gananoque got the scoring started off by a goal by Eric Selleck, Chad Duchesne, and Wyatt Cota were the assists. Then, after that, 4 straight goals by the Smith Falls Rideau, with Nate Slack scoring by David Bennett and Tim Morton. Brett Costello scored with assists from Nathan Slack. Ben Beasley scored with assists from Nathaniel Watson. And Andrew Muskinny scored with a goal from Andrew Spargu and Brett Costello. That's where we sit. We've had no penalties. It should be a good game moving on here out. We hope you're enjoying it. And please stay with us as we'll be bringing you back here the second period of play. And who knows what's going to happen in this game here, as it's the last game leading into the holiday break. We'll be back in the second period. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back here as we get ready to start period two. Again, just a recap, 11 shots aside in this first period of play. 4-1 for the Smith Falls Rideaus. We've had goals from Selleck, Slack, Costello, Beasley, and McKinney here today in this game. And we're about to get going here as the Gananoque Islanders are on the ice and the refs are on the ice. And now here comes the Smith Falls Rideaus. It's going to be a great game here as the Rideaus are leading it, but Gananoque always puts a little bit of fight back in them. We expect this period to come out. It should be physical. It should be fast. Get ready for some great hockey here, ladies and gentlemen, as this third period, or second period, is about to begin. Faceoff is going to be Eric Witzel and Cole Bouchard. Faceoff won by the Rideaus as they chip it towards the Gananoque zone and get it in as it's picked up by Liam Murray, who sends it up ice, chipped up to Selleck. Selleck sends it far ice as there's going to be a race for the puck. Mercier gets to it, chips it behind the net as Selleck will collect that over in the corner, has a little bit of problems with it as it bobbles on him, and he has to send it in the other way, picked up by Costello, who's going to stop up and send it to the blue line, chip back on by Caldwell. Caldwell puts it back to Costello, who's going to try to put it around the boards, but it gets stopped up with them. In comes Murray for a hit, but doesn't make too much of a connection as it comes out to center. Mercier has it, sends it over to the boards, but it couldn't get onto Selleck's stick as it's picked up by Witzel. Witzel leaves it back for Cobalt. Cobalt sends it up as a drive into the zone. Here comes Witzel. Witzel shot, and that one off the post as it comes back out. Shot now for the point, bouncing on the puck, and the helmet comes off of Cobalt. As Spencer Cobble tried to get a shot on it, took a little bit of a hit coming through in front of the net. We do have Leif Hertz in net right now, so Gananoque is sticking with the tender in there. Even though he does have currently right now a lower save percentage, we'll see what goes on here as they look like they'll be continuing with them. Stevens is going to come in to the faceoff dot. It's going to be Slack up against Stevens. Back one to the point. Comes shot. Hit a leg as it comes over to the sideboard. They're going to try to get onto it. A chip made by Duchesne, but it misses there. But now it comes out. Duchesne got it on a stick, but it got turned back around by Andrew McKinney. Picked up by Liam Murray. Chipped up to the boards. In drives Coda. Coda stops up at the blue, holding it, looking, sends it across ice as it bounces in behind the net. They're going to try to drive, grab that puck. It's in the feet of Duchesne. Duchesne staying down on that puck. Has two players pulling on it out, and out comes Slack with the puck, as he's going to send it up ice over to the far side as they're going to try to chip that one in, and it gets stopped up at the bench. Left there for Gananoque. Gananoque now driving it out of the zone, sends it up here to Coda. Coda makes a move, but puck gets chipped off his stick. Has Latimer pick it up in support as it gets left down for Coda. Coda comes in over the blue line, looking, shot. Save made by Slack as it comes over to the boards, and they chip it out of the zone all the way down. Tripped up play by Reese as he's going to get that puck in. Stopped up, is having a little bit of problem dealing with Pryor in behind the net there. He's going to need a little bit of help. Big hit by Mangan as that puck comes out. Diving on it is Hertz. And they'll get a whistle here with 17:55 in the second period of play. Into draw comes Mason Mangan, who will face off against Brock Boucher, as they're having a little bit of problems getting that puck dropped, and they're the feet of these two players. Puck dropped, one back to the point. Held on by Costello, shot, hit a leg, and bounces out as he'll be chased down here by Watson. Picked up by Costello. Costello dodges a little bit of a high bump there. No call coming. Now it's on Watson. He has stick as he's going to come in. Makes a move, tries to put it through the feet of Dixon. Dixon goes down with Watson as it looked like Dixon took out the feet of Wozniak. Goes in all the way. Hale chasing it down. Goes in around behind the net. Costello wraps it around the boards as it'll be cleared out. And now a race for the puck as it will be icing and come all the way back down into the Rideau zone. Setting up here. Messier comes in across from Nate Doman. Doman got back to the point where there's a shot on, but couldn't get through. Wozniak chips it off of the boards. Takes a hard hit, but there's going to be a drive coming in. It gets left up at the blue line. And Brown takes a little bit of a bump. As you can tell here, physicality picking up. Costello takes it into the zone, cuts through the slot, trying to bring through, but gets it broke off his stick by Doman. Doman now carrying it. He's not alone. Has Duchesne with him. Shot, and there's a goal. Puts it in to make it 4-2 here and give Gananoque a little bit of life back here in this second period of play. With 16:57 remaining here in the second period, Gananoque cuts down the lead to 2, and they're going to look to try to get right back onto it here off of this faceoff. As it's a scramble draw, it comes back out to the D's stick, over to Murray's stick. Murray has it, sends it over to this close side, onto Latimer's stick. Latimer chips it to Selick. He is able to get through. Selick chips it the blue line. Gananoque still holding it over to Murray. Murray comes through, shot, onto the net, and Slack makes the save. It comes over, a pinching Latimer keeps that puck in, onto Selick's stick, but it gets bumped off as they come over to the fireboards and they chip it out. Now back only is Murray. Murray comes in. He breaks that up. And what do we have here? We have a whistle. As I believe Slack was having an issue there, as it was the referee right beside Slack that whistled that one down. Witzel setting up across from Bouchard here at this faceoff outside the Gananoque bench at the Smith Falls line. Murray makes a good move, keeps that puck in. Now picked up by Mercier. Mercier carries in over the blue line. Shot high. Save made by Slack. And a quick whistle as Selick was barreling in on to Slack. Keep an eye on Selick as he's been known to get and a little bit of the rest up here for Gananoque. Face off one into the corner by Smith Falls, wrapped around the boards and over. Latimer pinching in, couldn't get a handle on it as it gets chipped out of the zone, only to neutral zone left for Murray, as Murray will backpedal it back towards Bouchard. Bouchard has it, sends it up to Selick. Selick coming in, holding it, shot just wide of the net as it goes over to the far side, misses everybody, and there'll be a foot race as Brown comes down to grab that puck, gets that puck, backpedals it over to Murray. Murray has it, tries to center it up ice as it hits a stick and will go down for icing. No, it doesn't have enough, and it'll get stopped up before, so Smith Falls will have to carry it back out of the zone. Good chip there made by Coda. Coda coming in. He's not alone. Sends it over to Shane with the big shot and goal. As Gananoque now has tied, taking it down to only a one goal lead. And what a goal that was by Duchesne as he ripped it by the far side of Slack. Gananoque does have a high powered offense, and Smith Falls does as well. That's why these two teams are sitting second and third here, both with 17 points this season. So we'll see which one is able to take the other one down. Gananoque draining a good comeback here, as they've had back-to-back goals. Cutting into this lead. Chipped up to center. Slack gets it, chips it back. Not sure. They are giving that to Doman from Morrison. Oh no, that was the first one. Sorry. Doman Morrison on the first one. Duchesne and Coda. Harrison, Duchesne and Cota get this game to one. And now Justin Stevens keeps in at the line, dealing with three Rideaus players. Slack able to get it turned back the other way, but it only comes to the point as they try to center it. Hits a stick, and they're able to turn and clear it out. Now an opportunity here for Andrew Spargrew. Sends it across, a diving poke check made there as Slack was coming in for that puck. Now Duchesne coming in, sets it across at the blue line, but it misses everybody, goes over the boards. Reese comes in, makes a hit, but the player looked like he was already losing his footing there. Now an opportunity, two on one, now a diving across, Wiley shot. And a big save made there by Leif Hertz, as he's put on a little bit of a show here late in this second period, trying to keep this game close and shut down any offense coming from the Rideaus. Based off in the feet, kicked back, grabbed up by Watzek, shot on and saved by Hertz. Back to the point, lays off one shot, misses the net, comes out to the other side. They chip it towards the net, but it does go in behind. Wiley chases it down, chips it, but now can't get a handle it as Nicholson kept it in. Now takes it across the other side, driving it up towards the blue line. Gets it in, takes a good hard hit there, and gets rubbed off the puck, but Gananoque still holding that puck as they're coming in. Mangan gets pulled down in behind the net. No calls, it's going to keep it going around as a cycle. Back to the point, shot. Slack makes a save, rebound. They can't get over to another shot, and the tip and the drive. In and a quick whistle by the ref as Slack is down on that puck. Face off one by Gananoque. Back to the point, try to back in it, but can't get it through. Now they're going to get it only in and then chipped out of the zone. Smith Falls has to leave it. Offside the call. No, offside. That should have been one as they didn't clear out. Missed by the linesman, but still didn't cost. Gananoque is now, here comes the drive. And it looks like a high stick call coming. And I believe that's coming to Eric Selleck as that stick got up. And we're going to see if there's blood, as it could be a 4-minute. As Selleck will make his way towards the penalty box, we'll see what the call is going to be here. Oh, it looks like that wasn't Selleck. They have 24 in the penalty box. Looked like it was Selleck to me, but I do apologize, Selleck. It was number 24, Cole Bouchard, who got that high stick. So Bouchard's in the box, 4 minutes on the board, as it's a double minor, as there was blood. So we'll see what happens here, as Smith Falls can utilize this to gain back their lead, if they can put a couple in here by Hertz. Power play percentage here for the Rideaus is 3.27, so we'll see if they're able to use it. They don't score on all of them. They do have a every third time, roughly, they're able to put one in, so we'll see. They can utilize that here, but an opportunity for Gananoque, shorthanded. And a great poke made there by Costello. Kept that one from costing the Rideaus. Rideaus now are going to try to get out of their zone as get a little quick change here for Gananoque. Caused a little confusion there. As now here they come in, shot high, save made, but couldn't corral it as it goes off. And now the Rivermen or Rideaus are keeping it going. Here's Witzel pinched out on the boards as it does get chipped to the blue. And now a drive, but Dolman couldn't cut through the D. Witzel gets that puck. Over to Costello. Costello driving in, going to center it. Can't get it centered. Takes a little bit of a high hick and a little bit of a shove over there by Costello as well. On the Gananoque Duchesne, no call coming as it's going to keep the cycle going here. You see Gananoque trying to keep that box in the lower shot. Off the post and then go in. Rebound save made by Hertz as that was a dangerous opportunity there for the Rideaus. Back to the point. Beasley sends it back down. There's going to be a drive shot. Puck out and a good clear made by the Gananoque defender. And that will be stopped up by Slack. Cota putting a little pressure as they're going to bring it over to this close side here. Pinched off by Stevens. As that puck kept in by Slack. Gets it in a low back to the point. Covered by Morton as Slack tries to drive it through. Back onto Morton's stick. Sends it back in. Drive here for Spragu. Sends it over to the far side and couldn't connect with Beasley as Gananoque is able to get out of the zone. But quickly grabbed up by the Rideaus and turned back the other way. Now a drive in. Puck left here as they're coming in with numbers. Shot and they have a goal. With 1:31 remaining, the Rideaus get another goal up on the board. And they'll make it here 5-3. The first 2 minutes though of the penalty to Bouchard did end, so that will be the only power play goal to be able to get on this one here. But Smith Falls has been able to answer to Gananoque's two quick goals with a goal of their own to get a two-goal lead back and hold a little insurance. Keeping an eye out right now is the next 10 minutes could be the prime time for one of these players to try to make a statement by maybe getting the crowd into it with a little bit of a fight off of Gann's side here. So we'll keep an eye out on that as we are getting to that prime time here in the game. Shot up off the glass and comes over to the close boards. As one of the Smith Falls player coming off the bench, wiped out, now up into the play. It seems no worse for wear, but definitely came in off hard off the bench. Now 2-on-1 opportunity, centered across. Couldn't connect with Andrew McKinney. McKinney holding it, sends it back over to the far side. As it's going to get in low, they're looking to center it to the slot. And they do, good save. Second save made by Hertz. And that puck goes off over into the corner, back to the point. Shot by Beasley, tipped on by Brad Hamilton. And that puck gets covered up by Hertz. .22 remaining here in this second period of play. Shots are 19 a pair, 19-19 is what they have on the score sheet. 19-22 is what they have on the scoreboard. Selick with that puck, gearing up behind his net, getting jumped on by a couple players as he gets that puck out of the way but couldn't keep possession of it. And that puck will get sent back in and deep as it gets picked up by Murray. Gets sent in around behind the net. They send it out, gets up high on to Bouchard. Now onto the stick of Selick. Selick centers it over to Mercy. Couldn't get it, but Murray coming in gets a shot off. Save made by Slack, picked up by Selick in the corner as he's trying to bring it out from behind the net. He does get out, shot by Stevens, and we have a goal. As Gananoque scores on a goal by Justin Stevens, assists Eric Selick. And I believe Liam Murray at 8:43, and Gananoque's cut into that two-goal lead, leaving it only to one now. And Smith Falls will have to look at getting it back, or Gananoque may be able to use this little bit of momentum to try to tie the game up. not sure exactly what's going on over here at the bench. Looked to be some issue maybe with Selick and Costello there. And the refs had got in there to make sure it cleared out. Eric seems to be fine. Score has prevailed, but we'll keep an eye on that as Selick and Costello didn't look to be too happy with each other. Good battle in there as Cota using the body gets into Shane on the puck. Centers it over. Slack makes a great save to bat that one away as they were crashing in, and icing will be the calls. It's going to come all the way back down into Gananoque zone. Face off to the right of Slack here deep in the Smith Falls zone. 8:23 remaining here on the clock. Back to the point. Wiley shot tipped on by Stevens and grabbed up by Slack as he'll hold it for a whistle. Cota comes back in again. Face off here, trying to win this one back. Gets into the feet of the official. Scramble. Duchesne going to get to it. Cota gets to it first. As he's being battled hard on the boards, pinched off. And that puck comes out. They still have not disengaged. Finally, now they're out as they come out. And that just onside as Cota was able to make it back over. Lots of complaints coming out of the fans here at the referees as they don't feel it's being called comparably here between these two teams. Opportunity, Wasiak shot, save, and a rebound, and we have a goal here. As he points to the camera, 6-4 is the score, and Smith Falls gets their insurance marker back again to the dismay of the Gananoque fans here. I said this is looking like this game back and forth could start into something as there's lots more chatter coming from the bench from Gananoque. As you can tell, they're getting fired up here. Not happy with the refereeing and not happy being down by two. Calvin Wasiak scored unassisted here to give the Rideaus the lead again. As you can see, the Rideaus continuing to pressure here on Gananoque. Shot from the slot. Very dangerous, but got gobbled up by the defense for Gananoque. Turned back the other way as it will be picked up by Dixon. Dixon sends it up to center, chipped in all the way down. As they'll go down, Slack stops that puck up. He'll leave it behind his net, and he gets hit by Mason Magan. Doesn't look like there's going to be a call coming for sure. I'm surprised nobody from Smith Falls has done anything about that. As this here is going to be a call, but again, I'm surprised nobody on Smith Falls did anything about that. They just let their goalie get hit. I'm surprised nobody took a shot at Mason Magan after he did a little bit of contact with Slack as he had lots of options and drove directly into Slack. So surprised to see no response at this point as they're going to try to score on the power play to try to make Gananoque pay. But right now, they allowed the Gananoque players to get a little physical with Slack. One by Murray, wrapped around the boards up to the point by Costello and all the way down. Slack's going to get that puck. Selick's coming in. Selick's getting in close to him. Selick puts a good hit there on Beasley. So Gananoque down. Again, we'll see what happens here. A little bit of rough stuff there between it. Looked like Latimer and the attacking Smith Falls player. But they come back out the other way. Now coming in is Cobalt. Cobalt centers it, and they couldn't connect with Spencer. That would have been a Cobalt to Cobalt goal. Now Beasley gets it, spends, or Witzel gets it, sends it back the other way, coming in on a call in the slot, shot, save made by Hertz. And you can see the frustration from Spencer Cobbold as he had an opportunity, just couldn't beat Leif Hertz here on the penalty kill. 5 minutes, 49 seconds remaining here in this second period, and a minute three remaining on the power play for Smith Falls as Gananoque is trying not to allow Smith Falls to get any more of a lead here. A little bit of connection in front of the net, but Leif Hertz makes the save. Face off in the feet of Pilon. Over to Sprague, holding on to it. Back to the point. D did a quick pass, but couldn't get a shot off. As now they're gonna hold, looking, driving in deep. Slack centers it. Couldn't get it, bouncing in front. Pinching in is the D to keep that puck going. As there's 30 seconds remaining on the penalty kill for Gananoque. Smith Falls keeping Gananoque hemmed in their zone. Back to the high slot, in deep. Couldn't catch that one cleanly. Now we'll send it back to the point. Shot, chip puck in, scramble draws. And that may have been a save made by Alex Reese. Now an opportunity as it comes over. Less people on this side, but a good puck made. Puck gets out of the zone, and Gananoque's penalty is about to come to an end. Now we're back to 5-on-5, and Smith Falls comes in offside, stopping the clock at 4:45. Faceoff up in the air. Latimer goes in to pinch on that one. Couldn't get it, gets chopped in. Hertz leaves it for him. He'll carry behind his net. Now coming out the other side, he has to cut back. Cut across, driving over center, in over the blue line. Still driving with that puck. Latimer has it, centers it. Couldn't get it to Shane, but then trailing in was Coda. Let's see what we have here. As slashing is the call, and I believe that might be coming to Mason Mangan. No, never mind, that's coming to Smith Falls. Number 28, Brad Hamilton slashing. I'm not sure, maybe Mangan was having something to say to the referee post bump with the goalie. Seems to be some discussion here from the coaching staff with the officials. Faceoff will be to the left of Slack, deep in the zone. One back into the corner as Coda goes in. That puck goes up and hits one of the lighting fixtures. And it's going to be a whistle and come back down in to the left of Slack. Faceoff, scramble draw, couldn't get to it as Smith Falls wraps around the far side all the way down the ice. Hertz will play it around. Murray stops up, sends it over to the side to Deshane. Deshane carries it, sends it up ice. Tried to get Coda sprung, but couldn't get to him. As it comes back now, over Deshane, as it's gonna go all the way down. Liam Murray's gonna pick that puck up, chips it back to Deshane, who has it. He has Salek back with him and Stevens, as Witzel was pressuring. Deshane chips it up ice. Now here comes Salek. He's gonna drive right through center. Drops off the Coda. Coda shot high up in the slack. Rebound grabbed up by Salek as he has it in there. Down low, gets it to Coda. Coda sends it out. Murray shot, and what a goal! As Liam Murray cuts that lead back down to one. What a one-timer shot that was from up in that juicy spot on the slot to give him a goal. It looks like it may be assisted by Stevens. And 3:30 to go. We have a one goal game here again, and that was scored on the power play. Little chatting here in the face-off between Mangan and Slack. And a good hard chip by Mangan, couldn't get in, then tripped up. Looks to be no worse for Air. McCarty got taken down on the way through to the net. No call coming, though. As Stevens comes out. Pressuring there. Faceoffs come back to the point. Dixon tries to get onto it. Chipped up, and we have a penalty call coming here to Slack for tripping. Slack got his stick into the feet of the Gananoque player, taking him down right at the blue line. And now the power play here again for Gananoque is going to have an opportunity to tie this game up late in the second period of play. Goda comes in across from Witzel. Face-off one, back by Coda, back to the Shane, over to Murray. Murray was the last goal scorer, back over to Shane. Shane sends it in, save made by Slack, picked back up by Stevens, shot from the point. Duchesne adds a scramble, draw there, now some shoving in on front as they're getting into Selleck's face, hoping to get a little bit of rough stuff out of him and maybe call, generate a penalty here and negate this power play. Little discussion coming out of Witzel to Selleck. We'll see if that turns into anything. 2:55 remaining. Face-off one back to Murray. Murray has it. Sends it in deep. Selleck has that puck on his stick. Back to the point. Duchesne has it. Shot to the far side. Can't connect with that as it's picked up quickly by Gananoque. Back to the point, but broken up by the Rideaus. And Gananoque has to turn back the other way. Hertz will leave it up on a stick here for Liam Murray. He stops up behind his net, waiting, pulls it out, has a little bit of pressure, does get that puck up and out. Now a drive in here for Selleck. Selleck's going to come in the zone. He drops it back, shot wide of the net as it's going to come around to the far board. Stopped up, send in to Coda. Coda has it on his stick, but it's bouncing. Murray keeps it in the zone, over to Selleck. Selleck has it, centers it, just out of the reach of Stevens. Chase for the puck. And Smith Falls is able to get out of the zone, but only momentarily. 2 minutes remaining here in this second period of play. 45 seconds remaining on the penalty. Slack comes out to get it. He'll get initiated by Bouchard. Puck picked up at the blue line by Stevens, in deep onto Selleck's stick. Selleck back to the point. Chipped right back over to Selleck. Selleck spins it around. Steven gets it in behind the net. He's getting roughed up by Nate Watson. Now Gananoque has it and try to center it, but they can't get it by Costello's stick on to Selleck's stick. And a play there as the Smith Fall player. I'm not sure. It looks like he might have been hit into Slack, but went in hard to Slack, and they blew the whistle right away. Slack has been having quite a night tonight as everyone seems to be crashing in on his crease. There's 19 seconds remaining on the penalty to Nate Slack. And a minute 28 remaining here in this period. 6-5 is the scorer. Smith Falls is just leading by one. Gananoque doing what they can to try to even the score here before the second intermission of play. Faceoff one back to the point, kept in by Latimer, chipped in deep. Bouchard trying to get on that puck, being stopped up. Mangan's there with him, and Mercier back to the point, on to Latimer's stick, over Mercier. Mercier holding it. Penalty over to Nate Slack. As we're back to 5-on-5 opportunity, shot towards the net, couldn't get it through. Gananoque still holding. As Slack's back into the play, centering opportunity, couldn't get it to the point. Latimer backhand hits a leg, and that one finally cleared by Duchesne as it's going to come down the ice. Mercier is going to get that puck here in this final minute of play, trying to bring that puck out of the zone. They're going to get it up to Duchesne. Duchesne carrying it over the blue line as he gets driven over the board, centers it, and a chip puck up and out of play. Cardi got a hold of it, but got under it just a little too much. Face off will come right here in front of us outside the Smith Falls zone of the blue line with 40.7 seconds left to go. Stevens comes in against Slack. Slack wins it back into his zone, chased down by McCarty. Now comes out to Doman Stick. Doman has it, sends it up ice. It's chipped in. Not enough raising, grabbed up by the Rideaus captain Costello. He'll hold it by his net. 23 seconds remaining. McCarty, only one pressuring for Gananoque. Costello's fine with holding this one out. Sends it all the way down the ice. Not enough racing. Murray's going to get to it. Wrap it around the boards. Comes up and out as he'll come all the way into the Smith Falls zone onto Costello's stick as he sends it through to center. Chopping at the puck, but is unable to settle it down. Both teams here making their way to the dressing rooms for the rest of the period. So what a great game has been so far. No shortage of goals, as we have 11 goals scored so far in these first two periods of play. And I'm going to get you some information here from the scorecard, give you an idea of what's gone on. So first period, we had 5 goals scored. Second period, we had 6 goals scored. So it's increasing right now. The shots, Gananoque 25, Smith Falls 28. We had here for the second goal scoring summary, Gananoque started off, Nathan Doman assist to Curtis Marison, then Chad Duchesne scored with assist to Wyatt Cota. On the power play though, Nathan Slack scored by assist to Calvin Watsiak and Ben Beasley, cutting into allowing Gananoque to continue their lead or continue bringing this game back. Then Gananoque did get an even strength one by Justin Stevens, assist to Eric Selick, and then on their right back within less than a minute, Smith Falls, Calvin Watsiak comes back with an unassisted goal. Gananoque scored by Liam Murray, assist to Wyatt Cota and Eric Selick on the power play to make it 5-6. That's where we sit. We've had a couple penalties. We had Cole Bouchard for high-sticking double minor. Mason Megan, 2 minutes for goal interference. Bradley Hamilton, 2 minutes for slashing. And Nathan Slack, 2 minutes for hooking. That's what's on the game sheet. We'll be back at the start of the third period. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We're back here for the third period of play, and there's going to be a little special going on here as I get this set up. They have, as you can see here, the Gananoque Islanders shooting board here. So they're going to be bringing out a little shooter here. And they'll be taking, I believe it's from the, guessing the blue line, maybe. Oh, the bottom of the circle. Oh! The ice still a little wet through the center ice area. That might get, maybe cause a little bit of issues for this little one here. You can see, not working the best right now as the water causing a little bit of an issue here. Now we go, as that one's gonna go just by. Oh, as they tried to get that one to go through. Good attempt there. Unfortunately, a little bit of water on the ice caused some issues. They did try. So as we are kicking down into the final seconds here of this intermission, the Smith Falls Rideaus are getting ready to come on the ice again. Aquaton is becoming on the ice. But as you can see on the camera right now, that is the officials as they made their way back onto the ice. Let me give you a little quick update of what took place here in the last period. 4 goals for Gananoque, 2 goals for the Rideaus in that second period of play. 14 shots for Gananoque and 17 for the Rideaus. We had a number of penalties in that, or a number of goals that second period. Doman scored, Duchesne scored, Slack scored, Steven scored, Wattiak scored, and Murray scored. A couple penalties as well to Heisig and Delmeyer to Bouchard. Goal interference to Mangan. We'll keep an eye on that one to see if anything else happens. Bradley got a slashing minor and Slack got a hooking minor. So that's what took place so far in the second period as they get ready to go here in this third period of play. As you see the Gananoque Islanders on the ice. And the Rideaus on the ice. Gananoque, but a good play there as they turn now, comes in. Mercer sends it over and a shot by Richard. Goes off over into the corner, battle on by Gasella, comes back up to the side boards as Selleck trying to reel that puck in, comes out on Bouchard's stick, over to Murray, Murray shot, blocker save made by Slack, over into the corner, onto it quick is Selleck as he had Latimer there as well, but they couldn't corral that puck back to the point, Latimer chips it right back to Slot, and a shot high and out of play off of the stick of Bouchard. Missed out on winning the 50-50 myself today. I had ending in 5-3-3. They had 6-1-0. So a little bit off myself, under 100, but it should be a good pot here as they have a great showing today. Buck one back to the line for Gananoque, chipped up, but turning it back is Smith Falls. They're going to cut over the line, cutting in through the slot. A little bit of a bump by the Gananoque players as that puck comes back and is intercepted. It's a little sloppy play here. Could be catching up as Smith Falls keeping the pressure going here. Opportunity in the slot as a drive cut across shot, and we have a goal. Scored by the Rideaus, bringing back their two-goal lead. So now Gananoque needs to figure out a way to get another goal and keep the Rideaus from putting another one back up on the board, as they only have 18:52 here to bring this game back. Both teams are tied with 17 points in the Western Conference. Gananoque sitting second, Smith Falls sitting third, but with a win here tonight, Smith Falls could leapfrog Gananoque. So they're going to be coming here to the face-off circle. Quickly, Gananoque wins that one back. D to D play as they're going to move that puck forward here and send it in down deep into the zone. Chase down the puck. Will be Gananoque setting opportunity. Broken up by the stick of Nate Slack and chipped out of the zone. And now in comes number 44, Robert, into the corner dealing with Dixon. Has Reese come in, but Reese goes over the top of the puck. Can't grab it. Has Dixon grab it back and hands it over to Reese. Reese now trying to get out of the zone and does get up ice. Now a drive here for Gananoque. Shot and a nice save made by Slack. Face off on the stick of the Rideaus, but with some problems with it in the slot. Coda tried to turn it over as it got chipped up to the board. Now it'll be grabbed up here on the stick of Latimer and sent up the ice as that's going to go all the way down. Misses everybody. Costello grabs that puck up and spins it back to center ice, and they're going to drive it in as Hertz comes in to stop it for Wiley. Wiley has it, makes a move as he does have some pressure coming from the Rideaus. As he chips up to McCarty, McCarty sends it up ice and just out of the reach of Mangan. A little deity play by the Rideaus as they get out of their zone, sent down the ice. Not enough for icing as it just missed being touched by a player. Wiley with the puck in behind the net, dealing with multiple players. Hurt coming onto him now, chipped out of the zone. Down ice, here's an opportunity. Stopped up by Hale as he dodged a hit. And now comes in, can't pull that puck off of Beasley's stick. Beasley chips it back to the blue line and out of the zone as they'll come over to Marison's stick. Marison sends it around the boards as they'll come on to Watsiat's stick. Watsiat bring it out. Marison comes in to break that one up. He sticks with it, chips it off the boards, but can't get that puck to settle down as he gets bumped out of the play. Now Nicholson holding that puck, keeping it as he chips it off the center, and we have a call coming. Looks like Spearing is going to be the call to Marison. So Marison's going to be going in the box here for 4 minutes on the board, which is going to give the Rideaus an opportunity to extend their lead here while they hold this two-goal lead. In comes Witzel. And it gets one over, but grabbed up by the stick. Two of the Gananoque players go down. It looked like Duchesne down the ice trying to sell that one. No call coming. Puck moved in by Cobalt, back out to Spencer Cobalt. The Cobalt brothers moving it back and forth, looking here, back out to Devin Cobalt. Centers it, can't get it to connect, but now picked up on the puck of Witzel. Witzel cuts back, can't get it, so he gives it to Beasley. Beasley carries it back in his zone, waiting for a little bit of support as he's pressured by Duchesne. Takes it behind his net and leaves it as it'll be grabbed up and driven out of the zone. Here comes Witzel. Witzel comes in over the blue, makes a good move on, drive to the net, and a shot, can't get it by Hertz. Another opportunity and a shot just wide of the net. Spencer Cobalt had the far side wide open, but his shot just missed the top corner and went up and out, and that's what caused the whistle to bring that puck out of play. 3:10 remaining on the penalty to Curtis Marison. Slack and Stevens gets in the feet. Stevens chips it back over to Dixon. Dixon sends it down the ice. As it'll be stopped up by Dallas Slack behind his net and left. It'll be picked up now by Brett Costello with some speed. Coming out of the Gananoque zone, up over center, in over the blue line. As he's carrying, tries to cut through the D and gets bumped as he goes through the zone. Wozniak comes in to hit Dixon. As now you can see the hitting turning up here a little bit more. And that's got to be a hit from behind. As no ref's arm goes up. As Selleck's in there shoving. I'm surprised. It looks like he got away with that one. As the referees may have put their whistles in their pockets now. Definitely. Looks to be one of those games where nobody knows what the consistency will be. Puck sent down the ice by Selleck and stopped up by Slack with only 2:10 remaining here on this penalty. And a drive coming in with some speed over the line, stops up, centers it back to the D. Good move there by Bennett, but he couldn't settle that puck down. Spin play back, holding on to that puck. Leaves that puck, Spragu takes it in behind the net. And that puck's chipped up and out of play. As he'll be chased down and grabbed up by Beasley behind his net. He'll stop up and then continue through. Being pressured by Brown. As they both go down hard here, close. On the board, sorry, that was Dolman who took him down, not Brown. As it comes out to the other side, picked up by Liam Murray, sends it back to Chris Latimer, who's gonna hold that puck, and he'll take it in behind his own net. Has Cobalt pressuring, he sends it up ice, but it's intercepted, as now coming back the other way with a move is Bennett, but he can't get that shot off onto Hertz as they turn it back the other way. Now an opportunity for again, as Coda tries to toe drag around Costello, but can't get by him. Costello turns it back the other way, Cobalt shot! And a save made by Hertz. As a little bit of a pull down there, and then a hit as Gananoque increasing the physical play here. Opportunity now, shot, save made by Hertz, rebound, and we have a goal. As it will be 8-5 here, and I can assure you there is going to be some discussion, as it looks like the referees have a difference in opinion on the goal. So we'll see what happens here, as the goal might stand. There could be some penalties coming. So there's going to be a penalty, one on each side, 1-2. Devin Caldwell, 1 to Wyatt Cota, it looks like. It does look like that goal was scored, as the original penalty is now off the board. So it will be 8-5, and Gananoque now only is going to have 13:32 to bring this game back. Or Smith Falls will leap them in the standings. Still no update on the 8th goal. They did bring the faceoff to center, so I would have to expect it is 8. We'll keep an eye on that. If it changes, we'll update the scoreboard, but it looks to me like right now. That goal was scored by Nate Watson, assist Eric Witzel, and Brett Costello. Gananoque now down 8-5. And they did have offsetting minors there. Here comes Smith Falls, still pressuring. No call, as Gann has an opportunity on a break shot, and a save made by Slack on Mercy. As they're going to turn it back, As it looks to me like Gann is trying to initiate a fight here, but Stevens on 12, or no, sorry, who was that back there? And now, Mangan is gonna drop the mitts, and he is trying, fighting here with Andrew McKinney with a bunch of quick punches. With the linesman in between. We'll see if anything else comes out. It looks like Beasley's being sent to the box as well here, as this has turned into a little bit of mayhem here late in the third period, with the score being 8-3, or 8-5. Gananoque starting to put a little bit of fight back in their game and taking some hard shots that might have been a check from behind. We will have to see what's called here by these officials. But so far, this game is getting quite a lot of violence between these two teams. You can see this is why they're second and third here in the West. These two teams, not big fans of each other. Rubbing after the whistle were the penalties to Wyatt Cota and Devin Cobalt. We'll see what gets put up on the boards here after this fight between Mason Mangan and Andrew McKinney. We do have the official having a conversation with Hertz. Not sure what they're discussing, but there was a little discussion going on there between them. We'll see. Definitely, this game here could definitely blow up if the referees don't get control of this game here late. Looks like nobody's going to be ejected here by the looks of things. As Ed Mercy comes in, takes a little bit of a bump there by Bennett. I said I expect this here, this game, starting to get out of control. So the initial call to Mangan is boarding, and Beasley will get the second penalty to even it up for unsportsmanlike. And that's where we sit with some 5-on-5 action. Sent down the ice, Gananoque gets on, opportunity here as that puck got in and got broken up, and now coming back the other way is Wozniak. Liam Murray gets on that puck first, sends it up to the neutral zone and goes up all the way through. He'll be chased down as in behind the net. A little bit of a trip up play there, but he gets the puck off to his partner, keeping Gananoque from getting an opportunity in the zone here on that trip up. But spun back the other way now. Here comes Duchesne, who's going to be all alone for a moment, waiting for some support. Puts it back to the point, but it was covered by the Rideaus. They bring it back the other way, 2-on-1, as Brown chasing down the pass. But the puck got broken up. Now Stevens coming back the other way. Stops up, sends it over, trying to get that puck in. Brown comes through, lays a hit down, and takes the the Rideaus player off their feet. No call coming as he's going to keep it in deep. Cobalt sends it across. And a save made by Hertz to stop up the play for a quick whistle. 10-17 remain here in this third period of play. Smith Falls has a 3-goal lead. Witzel comes in to the draw against McCarthy. One onto the stick, comes out on Reese's stick, who sends it around the far side onto Hale. Stick Hale sends it cross ice, and it'll be chased down. But Brown can't get to it as it's spun back now into the zone. Held by Witzel. Witzel trying to bring up to the line, centers it across, doesn't connect, but in driving is Cobalt, who chips that puck in and peels off from Reese. Reese comes in, lays a little bit of a body, comes onto the pick of McCarthy, who sends it around to the far side, but it gets out over the line as it can't be kept in by Beasley. Dixon has it, sends it around now up to center. Chipped up to McCarthy. McCarthy sends over to Brown. Brown shot, saved by Slack. And that rebound taken up, and it comes out. Offside is the call. And we'll stop play at 9:24. Faceoff coming to the dot here. In will come Bossier and Bouchard, won by Bossier, back into the Smith Falls zone. Smith Falls takes it in behind their net as they're driving through, getting attacked by the stick of Selleck. Couldn't get that stick, puck off his stick, flicked up and out of play. Will be a whistle. You can hear right now Beasley giving it to the official over the amount of slashes he took from Selleck with no call. Face-off won by Smith Falls, and they'll take it in behind their net. Costello stops up, but it comes down to the stick of Selleck. Centering opportunity shot. Save made by Slack to stop that one up. Face-off won. Back to the point. Shot by Murray up high, goes over, chipped on the corner, picked up by Selleck. Selleck tries to put it back to the point, but it gets by the D, a chase out here for it as Wozniak coming back. Murray tries to get on it, shot towards the net, comes off over to the far side. Nicholson shot in, dealt with by Hertz, and now picked up at the side of the net by Bouchard, sent up to Selleck. Selleck gets it through, chips it up. Now a break, or coming in, 2-on-1, over to Murray. Murray coming in, and he can't get it through as it's stopped up by Slack and then cleared away by the defense. Shot in by Wozniak. Big save made by Hertz. They'll come back the other way now. Stopped in Smith Falls zone. They do a little chop play and now drive it out of the zone. Bennett sends it down ice. Can't get it to connect as it goes on to Wiley's stick. Wiley holding it in the corner. Trying to get it out. Can't get it out. Stevens comes in to break that play up and chips it back around to Marison. Marison puts it back to where it came from, and it'll be picked up now by Gananoque as they're going to try to backhand it up the ice. Misses. Everybody goes down. Calling for an icing, but no icing as it's stopped up behind the net by Tim Morton, who's going to hold it. Has Duchesne pressuring and Coda, but gets it out. And they're going to break out of the zone. Coming out now, chipped in deep as Hertz is going to get on that puck and play it around the boards. But he'll be met by Bennett, who has Wiley pinch him off on the boards. Duchesne coming in, lays a little bit of a hit, and that puck comes out of the zone. And Wiley lays another big hit there. Another shove as we keep an eye, and we have a fight here. As Wiley has grabbed a hold of what looks to be, oh, an answer to the number on the play, but a good bunch of punches there. That was Corey Herbert from Smith Falls, and he put a couple punches into Wiley's unprotected head. I definitely will give that one to Corey Herbert, as Wiley got a couple good punches in, but Herbert laid into him as he got set. And that's the second tilt here tonight in this game. Coda now chirping with Hilbert as there's 7:28 remaining, which would give enough time for Hilbert to come out and challenge Coda. Although Code is not known for dropping the mitts. Five is the score here in this game. That's 7:28 remaining. What will come of this final 7:28? As at this point, it started to get quite physical. Marison coming right over to the penalty box to retrieve the stick. As Wiley's stick made it into the penalty box for the Rideaus. Here tonight and a score of 8-5. Gananoque, Smith Falls fighting for second in the West for this holiday break. Puck airmailed all the way down to the Gananoque blue line. Puck in play, as there'll be some shoving along the boards there. Reese comes out with it on his stick, brings it up to the side boards to Doman. Doman chips it over, and they're going to keep that puck moving down into the Smith Falls zone. 6:31 remaining as Gananoque running out of time here. Dixon battling, has Hale with him. Hale centers it. Now an opportunity for Bouchard. Shot, hit his stick, goes up, and out of play. Comes in across from Ross Clare. Richard wins it back. Shot from Murray in. Easily saved by Slack and put off over into the corner. Chipped out of the zone. There'll be a chase as Murray's going for it. Has Ty Nicholson in pursuit, but it's chipped off the boards. Goes off of the body of Sullivan. Couldn't be handled as now they keep bowing for it to the blue line. Grabbed up here by Mercer. Jay comes in, driving in. Shot goes off over into the corner. Picks up the rebound behind the net. Centers it. Couldn't connect with Sullivan. Back to the point. Murray keeps it in and chips it in deep. Picked up now by Gananoque. As they're going to cycle it in the corner. Bouchard tries to center it out, can't get it. A pinching in, Latimer chopped at the puck, couldn't get it, but he is able to break it up. And now on the second, Bouchard centered. Stella couldn't handle that one as it gets sent all the way out down the ice. And now we're enough for icing. 5:32 right now. The biggest enemy of the Islanders is the score clock as they're running out of time. Put three past Dallas Slack. Face off one over to the corner boards. Sent out of the ice and all the way down by Costello. That's going to go by the goalie for icing, and that will come right back down. And the refs are going to whistle, get right over to the bench to call off the Smith Falls players that were attempting to change. And they'll be brought back onto the ice. Gananoque now with their second opportunity here. I have to be able to try to use this tired crew and get one in as one more player being pulled back off the ice. Face off one back to the point. Shot just wide of the net. He's going to sweep out on the other side. Ted Nicholson jumping in on it. And he's able to get on his stick. It's a Gananoque player. Couldn't corral it. Now coming through the zone. Chips it forward. Comes into the Gananoque zone. But it'll be turned back now by the Islanders. But it's only going to come to the neutral zone and chipped right back in as Marison's going to run that puck down in behind the net. Having some problems as they battle against Andrew McKinney. Puck dug out, grabbed up by Coda. Coda sends it far ice. Up now, here's an opportunity as Gann's coming in, driving shot. Save made by Slack. Rebound picked up, cleared out, and comes all the way to Andrew McKinney at the point, who's going to send it up ice, trying to get an opportunity. Shot into the empty net, and that's going to do it right now, as now it will just be killing down the clock as a 9-5 score for Smith Falls Rideaus on the goal by Andrew Spargu. At this point of the game, we can't see there being too much rough stuff coming out, but you never know. Right now, this game is not sitting with very much of a possibility of getting up and bringing it back. They could do it, but four is a hard hill to climb, especially against the way Dallas Slack has been playing in this game. By everybody, back to the point, picked up by Murray, chipped in around the net. Cycled through, grabbed up by Doman. Doman has it, sends it towards the net. He's going to hit a body, go up and out of play, and we'll have a whistle. Face off to the right of Slack. Doman comes in to face off against Nick Pilon. Battle drawn in there on the stick. Quick shot by Doman. Rebound shot made. Saved by Slack. And another one as Slack grabs that one as well. Now some shoving in there. They don't know if we're going to see anything come out here of this. But they're getting into Slack's grill again. Caused one of the Islanders to get fired out of the pile. And now they don't seem too happy, as they want to go, but the linesmen aren't going to let go of these players. As there's still 4:10 to go. Looks to me like there's going to be no penalties, though, coming out of this. Lots of conversation here coming out between Selleck and what looks to be Slack. As Slack has been known to stand up for Dallas. We'll see if anything comes of that. Good hard shot in on Slack. And in again comes the Islanders right in on top, as they're going to come in, I'm guessing, every single play to pile in on top of Slack to see if they can initiate some emotions here out of these Rideaus. But Smith Falls right now only 4 minutes away from taking the second spot in the Western Conference. Battle along the boards. Puck gets out, sent all the way down, as there's going to be a foot race for it. Icing is going to be the call, so there's not going to be enough. And they'll both get there, but the whistle is gone, so they'll bring it back down the ice. And we have some rough stuff going on here in front of the net, as they got in with Slack. As you can see, the Gananoque player trying to fight Slack. We have a couple going on here. We'll go wide, as you can see. The little different melees going on here. As I said again, this is probably going to get out of hand here. I'm not sure exactly what happened. As we were following the play, I saw the initial, which would look to me like it was Slack and Duchesne that were in that one together. Duchesne, as you can see, eyeballing down Slack. He wants a piece of him. Slack waving bye to him. As that is definitely going to set off Gan here. If anything, Slack waving at Duchesne getting kicked out is probably going to initiate more bodies piling on to Slack in the remainder of this game. Duchesne's going to get an exit here on this one. But we'll wait to see what happens to see if the taunting there is going to cost Slack with a little bit of extra rough stuff thrown his way in the final 3:47. You can see Selleck there, not happy. with what's going on. I don't blame them. It is hard to say exactly what happened between Slack and Duchesne. Whether Duchesne got in there, it was after the whistle and in there, so we'll see what comes of this one. But if anything, this game is starting the rival between these two teams, sitting second, third, and definitely do not have positive vibes between each other. You can see Eric Selleck is on the ice. That usually is a sign that he might be coming out to, especially after an altercation, that might want to go out and maybe see if anyone wants to challenge him. Mangan's out there as well, has dropped the mitts this game. You can see Costello and Selleck having a little chat over there along the boards. I don't know if either of them will, anything will happen, but we'll see. It's looking like this game could have a wild final 3 minutes. Faceoff. One up by Smith Falls, taken in behind the net up to the boards and sent out. Chipped on and into the bench. And so far, nothing too crazy happening between these two teams after that little bit of a play between Slack and Duchesne. Again, Duchesne was ejected. Slack still in the game. Megan sets in across from Pilon, wins it back. Gananoque has the puck, sends it in deep. Megan now drops the mitts here with Alex O'Neill. It's obviously his second fight in the game, so he is going to get an ejection for this one. But you can see there's no love lost between these two teams. It looks like Megan took a good shot to the chin and locked up the arms and went down. Again, here, this game is not missing anything. Megan is going to be ejected as that fight started, and you can see here. The Smith Falls player being ejected right here below where the camera is. And we'll see what comes of this. 3:11 remaining. This game has had quite the action in the final 5 minutes of play. So the face-off is going to be just outside the Gananoque zone, or right across from their bench. As there's 3:11 remaining here, I reached out to a couple of the fans here in the stand to see if they saw what happened between Duchesne and Slack. It looks to me like Duchesne took a run at Slack there. We didn't catch that on the camera, but that is apparently what took place and what started that whole melee between Slack and Duchesne. So again, something to keep an eye on as these two teams meet again this season in Smith Falls. So another entertaining game here in Gananoque between these two teams. Not the outcome right now that Gananoque has wanted to have in this game, but definitely something keeping the fans going and excited. That puck turned back right away as Reese was sitting back at center. Puck chipped up at his own final, coming down to the final 2 minutes of play here. It looks like both teams have kind of cooled down here after that last fight. In the net, up. Turned over in the neutral zone. Now here comes Smith Falls. Continuing to pressure, send it across the ice. Couldn't connect with anybody. Has now be chipped up. Doman coming out of the zone, chips it in. Bennett had him lined up and ended up grabbing the puck off as Doman didn't want to take a hit. It's late in the game. Minute 40 remaining here as Smith Falls quite content sitting back behind their net for the remainder of this game. Gananoque not pressuring as they know they're down in the final minute 20, and it's not likely for them to be able to get four goals here in this final. Minute 15. So Smith Falls is going to be walking away here with the 2 points. They will have a game behind Gananoque. Gananoque still has a game in hand that will be able to catch up to them. But right now, going into the holiday break, it looks like Smith Falls is going to be taking the second place here in the Western Conference. And this, if anything, it should have started quite a little rivalry between these two teams. Opportunity for Bouchard, shot, save made by Slack, off over into the corner. Is that, will come back to the point, picked up by Dixon, sent back into the corner to Mercer, stick back around. As there's no one there, it's gonna come out of the zone and be picked up by Dixon. Dixon sends it to center, picked up by Bouchard, comes in, final 25 seconds. As in comes Morton, backhand chips it towards the net, chasing it down, but a good play there by the D. Morrison, break that one up. Morrison passes up to Murray. Murray chips it up out of the ice. 9 seconds remaining as that one's gonna come all the way down the ice. Slack's gonna come out to play it, and he'll stop it up, as that will do it here for this game. Gananoque puts no more pressure. This game here, Gananoque falls short to Smith Falls, allowing Smith Falls to leapfrog them in the standings. So Smith Falls will be sitting in second. Gananoque will be sitting in third place. Gananoque does have 17 points. Smith Falls will have 19 points at this point. The final shots here in this game, give you a little recap. Obviously, the score 9-5. The shots were 37 Gananoque, 34 for Smith Falls. Goals scored in the third period were by Bennett, Watson, and Spragu. And then there were a number of fighting penalties here at the end of the game. The one between Magan and O'Neill. There was the fight between Wiley and Herbert. The fight between Magan and Andrew McKinney. So 3 fights in this game. Great game, entertaining all around. Can't say enough. Slack stuck in there. Definitely, you know, a little bit chirping there from him after towards that was who was it? The guy in there, Trad Duchesne, who got in there. So definitely, you know, a little bit of chirping going on, waving bye to him, finding out that it did look like I didn't have the camera on it, but he did get ran by Duchesne. Didn't see it, but I did hear from the fans that they said that Duchesne ran into to Slack there. So could start anything here coming the next game. Let me see between these two teams right now. Both teams hold a win, and both teams have themselves a tie in this series. So series all tied up. And the last game will be at the, let me see, Smith Falls Memorial Center. And that will be on February 10th, 7:30 p.m. So if you can make it down to Smith Falls, check out that game. It's going to be a good one. I don't think I'll be there. It's not a home game. I always do the home games here. But you'll want to check that one out because it's going to be a great game. Great turnout today for the Gananoque Royals night here. And I think they got a good 50-50 pull in that stuff. So thank you for watching us. Thank you for tuning in. We'll see you guys in the new year.